Hello everyone, dear students. Today we'll begin with module 5, that is the structure. I'm going to teach about a new topic, that is structure today. So before we can begin with the structure, let us recall array. Let us study what are the limitations of array. We already discussed about array. Array is basically set of elements of the similar data type, that is a collection of elements of the same data type, that is homogeneous set of elements. So in the array we can store elements of the same data type. For example, we can have an array of integers, we can have array of floating point, we can have array of characters, that is called a string. We can have array of strings, we can have array of doubles. So that is how we can have the collection of the elements of the same data type. So one of the limitation of array is we cannot store the data of the different types. The different type of data we cannot store in the array. For example, if you want to store the information about the student. The student information basically consists of student name, student USN, student age, and student marks. So if you look at the student database, you take the name. So name is basically a string, that is character array. USN, that is also a string character array. Age, it can be integer type value, and marks, it can be float. So if you look at student information, it basically consists of different types of data, like name is a string, USN is string, and age is integer, and marks is float. So it is a collection of different types of data. So in such cases, we cannot use array, because array can hold similar typed elements, values of the same data type. So using array, we cannot store the student information. So in such cases, we need to go for a structure. So let us see how to define the structure. So structure is basically a collection of elements of the different data type. So array is basically a collection of the elements of the same data type, but structure is collection of elements of the different data type. So which are grouped together under a single name. That is, a structure is a collection of different data type grouped under a single name. So that is how we can define the structure. So let us see what are the difference between structure and array. So in array, we define array as a collection of related elements of the same type, whereas a structure can have elements of different types. Second difference is, an array is a derived data type, so that we already studied. But a structure is a programmer defined data type. A programmer can define a new type using structure, so it is called as a programmer defined data type. The third difference is, array elements are accessed using subscript. You know that array elements are accessed using index. So we take the index within the pair of square brackets. So that is how we access array elements. But the structure elements or structure members are accessed using dot operator. So that we will discuss later on. And the fourth difference is, order of array elements is very important. For the elements of the array, we need to maintain a specific order, because the elements are arranged in a contiguous manner in the memory location whose index will be starting from 0. But in case of structure, the order of structure member is not important. So these are the differences between array and structure. Now let us look at declaration structure. Let us see how to declare a structure in C. A structure can be declared using a keyword called struct. And the syntax of structure declaration definition is like this. It will begin with a struct keyword followed by structure name. Here structure name is the name of the structure. Any valid identifier can be used as a structure name. And the structure definition is going to be begin here and is going to end here. So a pair of curly braces is going to provide the definition of the structure. And within these two braces, we need to take the structure members. The structure member syntax is like a variable declaration, data type followed by member name. It is something like taking variable name and semicolon. So data type member 2, member 3, like this we can take n number of members in the structure. And structure definition ends with a closing brace and semicolon. So from a struct keyword to the semicolon, it is considered as only single statement or one statement. So that is how we can define the structure. Here, the variables are used to store the data, so which are called as the members of the structure. So So the variables are basically declared within the structure, called as members of the structure. Now let us take one simple example. If you want to store the student related information like name, US, and age marks, and if you look at this information, we need to store a different type of data. Hence, it is better to go for a structure to store the student information. So we are declaring a structure called student here. So let us go through the syntax here. So we know that the structure definition begin with the keyword struct keyword followed by name of the structure, that is student, and the structure definition begins here, and we'll take some of the variables or fields, so which are called as structure members, where we can store the student information. Like the first member is name. So name is basically a string. In C language we already learned that strings are represented as character arrays. So let us take a character array here with the size of 50, and array name is name. So name is basically a string variable with the size of 50. So this is the first member of the structure student, where we can store the student name, and the second member is also string, that is USN, where we can store the student university seat number. Third one is age. So this is the third member of the structure student. So in this particular member we can store student age. So and its data type is integer here. And the last member of the structure is marks, whose data type is float here. In this we can store the student marks as a floating point value. And so this is the end of the structure. It is ending with a semicolon. Now let us see declaration of the structure variable. Once you define a structure, so let us see how to create variables of the structure. So there are two different ways to create structure variables or to declare structure variables. First one is called as a tagged structure. It means when a structure is defined, it creates a user defined type, but no storage will be allocated. So now let us see the syntax of declaring variable. It's very simple. You have to begin with struct structure name followed by structure variable 1, comma structure variable 2, comma structure variable 3, and so on. So like this we can have n number of structure variables, and it should end with semicolon. For example, for the structure student, so we shall create its variables using this particular syntax. It is very simple here. So we can take a struct keyword like this, followed by name of the structure. The name of the structure was student, and followed by the structure variables. Your structure variables are S1 and S2. These are separated by comma. It ends with semicolon. So there is another format of declaring the structure variable. So in the structure definition itself, we can create or mention the structure variables. Like the syntax is struct structure name, and we'll have the members here like this within the structure definition. And before we can end the structure definition with the semicolon, here itself we can mention the variable names like structure variable 1, 2, and so on. For example, you take the struct student, and it is having the members as a name as an array of character, USN as an array of character, both are strings here. Next one is int age and float marks. And before we take semicolon, here itself we are taking structure variable names S1 comma S2. So it is the same as this one. We can use any one format here. So one thing you have to remember, every structure variable has got its own separate copy of structure members. For example, there are two structure variables S1 S2. S1 will be having its own separate copy of the members name, USN, age, and marks. So similarly, structure variable S2 will be having its own separate copy of name, USN, age, marks. So S1 is representing one student, and S2 will be representing another student, and the student data of two different students will be different. And let us see what is the second way of defining or creating structure variable. So here we can make use of a keyword called a type df. The type df basically indicating defining type. So it is possible to define a new data type of the structure. Type df is a keyword used to define a new user defined type of the structure type. So let us see how to use it. Let us take the student example here. So it's a struct student with the members like name, USN, age, marks that we already learned. So this structure definition is prefixed with a keyword called type df. So before struct keyword, we are using another keyword called type df. So type df is basically a keyword used to define a new structure type. So before the semicolon, we have to define the type here, type of the structure that is student. So instead of using a struct student, what we can do is we can use this particular student directly. Student followed by variables s1 comma s2. Otherwise, we'll have to take it as struct student s1 comma s2 that we did in the previous slide. So instead of that, what we can do is we can use this student in place of struct student. Okay. So the variables are s1 comma s2. So this statement is declaring two variables s1 s2 of the type student. So that is equivalent to struct student. So the student is same as struct student. So because of type df, we can use this as a data type. So student will be data type and the variables are s1 s2, but the student will be of the type struct student. So the data type student is basically representing a structure student, and variables of the structure are s1, s2. So we are following the variable declaration syntax here, like data type followed by variable names. Now let us see how to access members of the structure. To access members of the structure, we can make use of dot operator. The syntax is very simple. Structure variable name dot member name ends with semicolon. So this syntax we can use for accessing structure member. So we already declared a structure called a student with the members as name, USN, age, marks. Now let us see how to access these members using dot operator. If s1 is a structure variable name, s1 is a variable of the structure student, then the structure members can be accessed like this. S1 is a structure variable name, then dot operator, then the structure member name, that is name is equal to, we can take it as Ravi. Similarly, s1 dot usn, we can assign some usn here like 2HN98CS030, and s1 dot age is equal to 20. So what we can do is we can have the structure variable, then a dot operator followed by member name, structure member name is equal to its value can be assigned. So that is how we can access structure members. Now let us see how to initialize structure variables. So that is what structure variable initialization. So initializing structure variable is very simple. Let us look at the syntax of structure variable initialization. So we can take a struct and the name of the structure followed by structure variable is equal to, and within a pair of curly braces we can provide a list of values for the different members of the structure. So let us take the example of struct student. So let us see how to do this. Struct student, the variable name is s1 is equal to, and within a braces we'll have to provide the value. For the first member name, the value is Ravi, and for the second member USN, the value provided is 2HN98CS030. So both are strings here, hence they are put into a pair of double quotes. That is the V represents string in C. The third member is age here. So let us take age of the student as 20. So that is the third value are assigning, comma, and the last value are assigning is 65.0. The first value Ravi will be assigned to the first member of the structure student, that is s1 dot name will be Ravi. The second value, that is s1 dot usn, will be 2HN98CS030, and the third member s1 dot age will be set to 20, and the fourth member s1 dot marks will be set to 65.0 automatically. Now let us see how to read and write structure variable. So to read a value for structure variable, you can make use of a scanf function. Like for example, if you want to read a value for the first member of the structure student, that is name, which is of the type string character array, so we can use scanf like this. Scanf, the type specifier here is percentages, because you want to read a string value, comma, here we can take member name. So member name is basically should be taken in this way, that is a structure variable dot member name, so that is s1 dot name. So you are reading a value for the first member of the structure student, that is name. So even it can be done like this using get s, like s1 dot name is equal to get s function can be called, which can read a string and it can be assigned to s1 dot name. Suppose that you want to read a value for a structure member age. So age is basically declared as an integer in the structure definition. So for the integer, the type specifier is percentage string, comma, you must take ampersand here, but for the reading string, ampersand is not required. So that we already learned. So since we are reading integer value for age here, you must take ampersand. So that is address of operator, then structure member name. So it should be access like this, s1 dot age. Similarly, if you want to display the values of the structure members, we can use the printf or putf function for the strings. So printf, the type identifier here is percentages, comma, you want to display the value of name of the structure variable s1, so it will be like s1 dot name. So it will display the value of s1 dot name on the screen. So even it can be done like this, put s of s1 dot name. So if you want to display the value of s1 dot age, so we can use printf, the type specifier for integer is percentage t comma s1 dot age. Here it will display the value of s1 dot age. Now let us take a simple program to demonstrate the structure. So write a C program to create a structure called student with fields or members, name, USN, age, marks and gender. Read the details of students and display it. So this program is very simple. So we will have to begin with hash include std.io.h. Then we have to define a structure with the name student. So let us follow the syntax of structure declaration. It will begin with a struct keyword followed by name of the structure. So let us take the name of the structure as student here. Then we will take the open brace, and inside that we will have the fields or structure members. The first field is the name here. The name must be taken as a character array because it's a string. So you are declaring a character array with a size of 30. So this statement is declaring a string variable name with a size 30. So similarly, we can create another character array with the name USN of size 30. So it is representing a string variable USN with size 30. Third one is integer variable age, where we can store the student age. And last one is the floating type variable marks, where we can store the marks of the student. Then we take closing brace. Then it should end with the semicolon. The structure definition begins here and it ends here. From here to here, it will be considered as only one statement. Then we will have the main function, and inside the main function, let us create a variable of the structure. So we already learned the syntax of declaring variable of the structure. The syntax is struct structure name, then variable name. So in this example, struct, the structure name is student, followed by structure variable name. We can take any name here. So in this program, we have taken the structure variable name as std1, and it should end with semicolon. Next, we have got the printf. So that is a message we print on the screen for the user, that is enter the details of student. So enter the details of student, that is a message we display for the user on the screen. And after that, we have to read the details of the students here. Printf will ask user to enter name here. And then we are supposed to read the name using scanner. So basically, you are reading the value for the first member of the structure, that is name. So in the scanner, the type specifier is percentages, because we are reading a string, because name will be string here, comma, variable name without using ampersand, we have to use the structure member here. So the structure member can be accessed using dot operator that we already studied. The structure variable is std1 here, std1, then dot operator, we can followed by, we can have the member name. Member name is name. Okay, it will be like std1 dot name. So this scanf statement is reading name and it will be stored into std1 dot name. For example, if you enter name as Pranav and it will be stored into name. So std1 dot name will be Pranav. Then printf usn. So we will display usn and using scanf we ask user to enter usn and it will be stored into the structure variable usn. It will be accessed like this, std1 dot usn. So if you enter usn as 2hn19cs026, it will be stored into std1 dot usn. So similarly, printf age and we'll ask user to enter age here and you are reading age of the student using scanf here, %c, ampersand std1 dot age. So again you are accessing the third member of the structure here using the variable std1. So this statement reads an integer value and it will be stored into the structure member age. If you enter 20 here, std1 dot age will be set to 20. So similarly, printf marks, then use scanf here, and the types is fair for marks is %f because the data type of marks is float here. So %s, f, ampersand std1 dot marks. If you enter marks as 75, it will be stored into std1 dot marks. Then we'll have to display the student details. We have the printf student details bar. So we display this message. Then you display the values of the structure variable. Printf, we have the label here name followed by std1 dot name. So std1 dot name is basically the first member of the structure which is holding the value as Pranav. So that will be displayed here. So similarly, usn, it will display std1 dot usn. The value it is storing here is 2hn19cs026. usn is equal to 219CS026. The next statement, again it's a printf where it is printing the value of std1 dot age. So the output we get here is age equal to 20 because the value of std1 dot age was set to 20. Finally, we display the marks. So marks is equal to, it will display the value of std1 dot marks. So its value is 75.000 because the marks is basically floating point. So that is the output we get here. Now let us run this program and check the output. So we go to online GDB for execution of the program. So what I do is I'll run this program. Okay. Enter the details of student. It is asking us to enter name here. So let us enter name as Pranav. Next, it is asking us to enter USN. So let us take USN as 2HN19CS029. So that is USN. Then age equal to 20. Marks equal to 75 and this is the output we got here. Okay, the student details are, so this is the output we got from this program. So that is how we can execute the structure programs. Now let us continue with the next topic. The next topic is the nested structure. It is the structures within the structure. A structure can be defined within and the structure, that is called as nested structure or structures within structure. So we can create nested structure in two ways. The first one, placing complete definition of a structure inside the definition of another structure. So that is first one. Second, a structure is defined separately and a variable of structure can be placed inside a definition of another structure. So let us take example for the first one, that is placing complete definition of a structure inside the definition of another structure. And its example is here. You are creating a structure called student. So this structure begins here and it is closing here, and its members or fields are, the first one is name, second one is USN, both are character arrays representing string with a size 50 and 10 respectively. The third field is int age, fourth field is float marks, and within the definition of structure student, we are defining another structure called struct date. So that structure is nothing but nested structure. So struct date is a nested structure. Struct student is called as enclosing structure. So this structure begins here, it ends here, and it is having its own separate members like int day, int month, int year. So struct date is representing basically date. So that is date of birth of the student. So that is indicated by a separate structure definition called date here with the members day, month, year. If you look at date, it is having three fields, date, month and year. So it is put into a separate structure called date, and it's a variable is created here called DOB. DOB stands for date of birth, it ends with semicolon. So this particular structure begins here, it ends here, and it is having three members, day, month, year. So DOB will be having day, month and year. And the outer structure is going to end here, and its structure name, structure variable name is S here. So S is the variable of struct student. DOB is the variable of the structure date here. And structure date has been nested within another structure called student. Now let us take the second way of having an extra nested structure. So let us look at the example here. It's a struct date here with the members day, month, year, all are integers, and it is ending here. And we have another structure definition called student, and it is having the members like name USN, then age marks, and if you look at the last field, it is basically a variable of the structure date. So it is struct date DOB. So this is the end of struct student here, and its variable is yes. So both are equivalent here. So these are the two different ways of having nested structures. Now let us see how to access the members of nested structure. So that is accessing nested structure members. So let us look at the syntax. The syntax is very simple. Outer structure variable dot inner structure variable dot inner structure member. So if you look at the previous example, the outer structure variable is S here, and the inner structure variable is DOB. Here also, outer structure variable is S and inner structure variable is DOB. So now let us see how to access members. The syntax is outer structure variable, that is S, dot inner structure variable DOB dot, and the inner structure member, that is day, for example 20. So similarly, S dot DOB dot month equal to 3. S dot DOB dot year is equal to 2018. Now let us take one program here. Write a program to create a structure called student with fields name, age, marks and DOB. Read details of students and display it. So hash include stdio.h. So we already learned about type DF. I'm going to make use of type DF here for the structure definition called struct student. It is going to begin here, and the members of this particular structure are, the first one is name, second one is USN, both are character arrays, third one is int age, fourth one float marks. So this is basically nested structure we are demonstrating here. We are defining a structure called date within struct student. The fields of data are int day, int month and int year, and the variable of the inner structure is DOB, and the variable of outer structure is student. So it is basically declared as type DF. So student will be the user defined data type of the struct student. Now let us see how to read the details of students and display. Then we'll go to main function. So we'll take the variable of student here. So student is a type definition of the structure student. So this is basically a variable of what I can say outer structure. It's called as outer structure variable. Printf enter the details of student. Printf name. So let us read the name here. So you are reading a value for a member of outer structure, that is name. So it can be accessed like this. So scanner percentage comma s dot name. Similarly, printf usn read a value for usn, that is s dot usn. Printf age, enter value for age here, like scanner percentage d comma and percent s dot age. Printf marks. So you are reading the value for the next member, that is marks, s dot marks. And after that, printf will ask user to enter date of birth in this particular fashion, like dd hyphen mm hyphen yyyy. So that is the date, month, year will have to enter. So that is date of birth of the student. So let us see how to read the date of birth here. So here we will be making use of inner structure members, so which is representing date. So the inner structure members are day, month, year, all are integers. So in the scanf you are taking type identifier as percentage d. So 3% d will be taking here, comma, the first one will be the day. So how to access the inner structure members, let us see. The syntax is the outer structure variable, that is x, comma, inner structure variable, it is declared as a DOB, that we already discussed, dot inner structure member, that is day. So you are reading a value for day. So similarly, the second one is s dot DOB dot month, so that is month field. The third one is s dot DOB dot year, so that is year field. So that is how we read the student details. Now we shall display the student details. The student details are, let us print name with the printf here, like name, you are displaying the value of s dot name, usn, display the value of s dot usn, age, s dot age, display marks, that is s dot marks, display the date of birth of student in this fashion here, percentage d hyphen, percentage d hyphen percentage d, it is basically a day, month, year. So here we shall substitute s dot dob dot day. The second percentage d is replaced with s dot dob dot month. The third one is replaced with s dot dob dot year. So that is why we display student date of birth here. Now let us run this particular program and check the output. I'm going to put comment for this particular program that is already executed and check the output. Now we are demonstrating the nested structure program here. So changes will be saved first. Let me run this program and check the result here. Okay, it is asking us to enter student details. So let us enter the name as, for example, Priyanka, USN, 2HN, 90, CS, 0, 3, 0, age, 20, marks, for example, 70, then you have to enter the date of birth. The format is the DD, that is for example 23, month 05, year 2000. Now it is going to display the student details here. The student details are, name is Priyanka, USN 2H19, CS030, age 20, mark 70.00, and date of birth is 23/5/2000. So that is the output we got here. Now we shall discuss about array of structure. Actually, we can create an array of structure variable. For example, if you want to store the details of all the students of your class strength is 24. If you want to store the details of all 24 students, then we need to create an array of structures. So that is the syntax of creating array of structure variables. The syntax is very simple. Struct, structure name, structure variable, and within the square brackets we'll have to mention the size. The size is basically how many structure variables we want to take here. So that is an array of structure variable it is going to create. For example, so struct student s of 100. So the statement is creating an array of the structure student with size 100. It means here we can show the details of 100 students maximum. The first student details will be stored at s of 0, and the next student details will be stored at s of 1, s of 2, s of 3, and so on. And the last index will be 99 here, and each element of this array will be having the different fields of structure student, and there actually we can store the value. Now we can take a simple program to demonstrate array of structures. So that is, write a C program to create a student structure with fields name, USN age, marks, and date of birth. Read details of n student and display it. So we'll begin with hash include std iowa.h. Then we have the structure definition. It's a type df struct, and the name of the structure is the student here, and the structure begins here, it ends here, and the members of the structure are, the first one is name, second USN, both are character arrays. The size of first array is 50, and the size of second character array is 10 here. And the third field is age of the type integer, fourth field is marks of the type float, and there is a nested structure here called date. It is representing a date, actually having three fields, day, month, and year, all are integer type. And DOB is a structure variable of the structure date, and student will be the type definition of the structure student. Now there is a main function, void main. So inside this we are creating a array of structure variables. We take the data type as student here. Student is basically defined as a struct student, and we have taken array s of size 10 here. So s is basically it is an array of structures, and it is having a size of 10 here. So it is basically an array starting with index 0, that is s of 0, s of 1, s of 2, s of 3, and so on. And the last element of this array will be s of 9. And each element of this array will be having the structure fields like name, USN, age, marks, and DOB. And we need to provide, or we need to provide values to these fields in this particular program. So next we shall declare some integer variables like int n and i. Next we have a printf, enter number of students, and you are reading the number of students. Scanf will read how many student details you want to enter here, that is the number of students. Here the value of n should be less or equal to 10, because we have taken the size of the structure array as 10 here. So maximum 10 students details we can enter here. So n must be less than or equals to 10. Now let us take a for loop. So we'll have to start from I is equal to 0, because you know that array index will start from 0. So this is also an array, but it is of the type structure student. So here also the index will be starting from 0, that is s of 0 to s of 9. So that is why take a for loop and start from I equal to 0. The condition is I less than n, I plus plus. This for loop begins here, it ends over here. So in this particular for loop, we have to read the details of all n students. So next we have a printf, enter the details of student. First of all, we read name here. So first we print name, and we read the name using scanf here. The first field of the structure student is name, and you are reading value for that particular member here. So it's a character array which is string here. So we take type specifier as percentages, comma. So Here we have to take index of index in the array here, that is s of I dot name. So initially I will be 0, so it will be like s of 0 dot name. So you are reading the details of a student, it will be stored at s of 0 and its field is s of 0 dot name. So similarly we have to read usn. So here you should read a value for s of I dot usn, that is second member of the structure student. So similarly we read age here, that is s of I dot age. For first student I will be 0, it will be like s of 0 dot age. So similarly read the marks, s of I dot marks. Next we have to read the date of birth of the marks, scanner. We know that date of birth is basically defined by a nested structure called date. It is having the fields like day, month and year, and there is a structure variable DOB. So we need to use that particular DOB here. So in the scanner we will be reading day, month, year. For that you have to take type specifier as %. So we will have to take 3% these here. The value you are reading here are day. So how do you access a day field here? So day is basically a member of a nested structure date, so which is nested within and the structure student. So we require two references. So that is the outer structure variable, it will be s of I dot inner structure variable, it's declared as DOB dot inner structure member, that is day. Similarly we'll have to read s of I dot DOB dot month and read value for s of I dot DOB dot year. So we'll have to read day, month and year. So that is what date of birth of the student. So like this, so this for loop is going to be executed n times. So we'll read the details of n students here, and after that we'll have to display the details of all n students. Take a for loop, start from I equal to 0, I less than I plus plus. So using printf we'll be displaying the details of all the students. So in the printf we'll have to take it as s of I dot name. So here we'll have to print the details of I student, and value of I will be ranging from 0 to n minus 1. If you take n equal to 5, and the value of I will be from 0 to 5 minus 1, that is 4. So we'll have to take s of I dot name, s of I dot usn, s of I dot age, s of I dot marks. So we'll display the details like name, usn, age, marks of each and every student here, and after that we'll display date of birth using printf. So it will be a very simple program. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is the structure and functions. Now let us see how structures can be used in the functions. So structure can be passed as a parameter function, and there are three different ways to do that. First one, we can pass the entire structure as a parameter to function. So here passing actual value as the argument to the function. Second one, passing address of entire structure. So here in this case we are passing address of a structure variable to the function. So that is second method. Third one, passing individual members. So individual member of the structure we pass as a parameter to the function. So like this, there are three different ways to pass structure as a parameter to function. So let us begin with first one, passing entire structure as a parameter. It is basically pass the value only. The values of structure member will be copied into the formal parameter of the function, and whatever changes we make in the function is not affecting original values. So we can pass entire structure as a function argument just like any other variable. When a structure is passed as an argument, it is passed using the call by value method, that is a copy of each member of the structure is made. If the call function is returning a copy of the entire structure, then it must be declared as a struct followed by name of the structure. The structure variable used as parameter must be same as that of actual argument in the call function. When a function returns structure, then in the calling function the return structure must be assigned to a structure variable of the same type. If the structure is passed by value, change made in the structure variable in the function definition does not reflect in the original structure variable in the calling function. So let us take a simple program to demonstrate this particular concept. So this in this program we are passing entire structure as a parameter function. So in this program we'll begin with hash include std::io.h. So then there is a structure definition. So it will begin with the struct keyword followed by name of the structure. It is a student here, and the structure definition begins here, and it is having the two members. The first one is a name, which is a character array representing a string having size of 50. Second one is a int roll number. So this is the end of the structure. It's a closing brace, ends with semicolon. The structure begins here, it ends here. It is having the two members, name, roll number. Name of the structure is student here. So there is a function we are defining. The function return type is void. It means the function is not going to return any value to the caller. The function name is display. It is taking a structure variable as a parameter. So this is formal parameter function. So the parameter is of the type struct student. So that is why we find here parameter as struct student, and the parameter name is stu. So inside this function you are printing the values of the members name and roll number. So we have taken a printer. Your name is, we take the percentages as a type specifier, because the first member is a string here, and we print its value by using stu.name. So stu is the structure variable, and we use the dot operator, then we access the member. Member is name here. So it will display the student name. The next one, similarly we display the roll number. Printf, your roll number is equal to %d, comma stu.rollNumber. So here the roll number of the student will be displayed. Now next we have got the main function. So in the main function, this display will be called here. So inside the main function we are creating a variable of the structure student by this struct student s1. S1 is a structure variable of the struct student. Now printf enter student name. So we have written the student name using scanf here. So percentages comma ampersand s1 dot name. So you are reading value for the name field, that is s1 dot name. Similarly printf enter roll number. So scanf is used here to read value for the second member of the structure, that is roll number. It is accessed using structure variable with the help of dot operator. So scanf percentage comma ampersand s1 dot roll number. The second field is accessed through variable s1 dot roll number. Suppose that if you enter name as Rama and roll number as 149, so s1 dot name is Rama, string Rama, and s1 dot roll number is equal to 149. Next we call the function display, and the structure variable s1 is passed as a parameter. So entire structure is passed as a parameter to the function, but actually it will be acting like a call by value. Only the values of its members will be passed here. So that is what. So s1 is having two members, name and roll number, with the values Rama and 149 respectively. So the value of s1 will be copied to, so s1 is basically called as a actual argument, and it is passed to the formal argument stu. Only the values of name and roll number of s1 will be copied to stu. So that is stu dot name will be, that is equal to s1 dot name. S1 dot name is holding a value Rama that is assigned to stu dot name. So only the value has been copied here, and whatever changes we make to stu dot name, it is not affecting s1 dot name in the main, because it's a call by value. So stu dot name is set to Rama here. Similarly, the second member of s1 dot roll number will be copied to stu dot roll number. So that is stu dot roll number will become 149. So control will be transferred to the function definition. Actually there we print your name is equal to, if you print stu dot name here, it will be Rama. It has got printed here. Similarly, your roll number is equal to, if you print stu dot roll, it is going to print its value, that is 149. So that is a, we can pass entire structure as a parameter function. So it is basically representation of call by value. And another way of passing parameter is passing address of entire structure.
if you pass address of entire structure to the as a parameter of the function, then whatever changes we make in the function definition is affecting original structure members. So that is, the address of structure variable is passed to function while passing it by reference. When the address is passed, pointer should collect the address. If the structure is passed by reference, changes made in the structure variable in the function definition is reflecting in the original structure variable in the calling function. In this case, the structure member can be accessed with the help of an operator called as arrow operator. So this is made up of a minus symbol and greater than. So that is called as arrow operator. And the other one is individually we can pass structure member as a parameter. So that is the third method of passing parameter to the function, structure parameter to the function. Now let us take a simple program to demonstrate passing address of entire structure to the function. So in this program, we'll begin with hash include stdio.h. Then there is a function declaration. Its return type is void. Function name is list here. It is taking one parameter, struct student star stu. So this star stu indicates it's a pointer. So we already learned that. So in this particular program, we want to pass address of a structure variable here. To collect the address, we need to declare for this structure variable as a pointer. So we'll be discussing about pointer later on, but we have to take stu as a pointer here. To indicate the structure variable stu as a pointer, just we need to add a star before this, then it will make it as a pointer. Next, we'll have the structure definition. It begins with a struct keyword student. It is having two members, name, which is character array, representing a string. So name is a string variable with the size of 20. Second member is int roll number. So this end of structure, there should be some semicolon. It's missing here. We'll have to take a semicolon. Then we have the main function. So inside the main function, let us declare a structure variable. We know the syntax. The syntax is struct student, and the structure variable name is s1, ends with semicolon. So this s1 is having two fields, that is name and roll number. Next, we have to enter the value for name and roll number. The printf enter the student name, scanner s1.name. You are reading a value for the structure member s1.name. For example, if you enter the name as bond, it will be stored into s1.name. So the s1.name is basically set to bond. Next one is the printf enter roll number. Scanner statement is going to read a value for the structure member roll number. The roll number is of type integer, so you take type specifier as %d, comma, ampersand s1.rollNumber. So the scanner is reading an integer value for roll number. If you enter 007 as a roll number or bond, it will be stored into the variable roll number. Then we call disp function here. So the disp function is defined like this. So let us see the definition of disp function before it is called. So its return type is void, and it is taking a pointer to structure as a parameter. So stu is a structure variable, but it is declared as a pointer. This star indicates stu is a pointer which can take address of another structure variable. Now, so whenever this function is called here from the main, we need to pass address of the structure variable s1. To pass address, we make use of ampersand, which is called as address of operator. So this function is called with the parameter address of s1. The address of the structure s1 will be passed to the formal parameter stu, which is a pointer to structure. Now stu is containing address of the structure s1. The entire structure variable s1 is passed with its address to stu. Now stu is referencing s1, and whatever the changes we make to the values of name and roll number through stu, it is also affecting s1 inside the main function. So in the disp, what we do is we display the value of the fields name and roll number. Okay, let us see how to do that. So we take a printf here, and we print name is, the type specifier is %s, because it's a character array, which is string. So this is new line, comma, So one changes we have to observe here. To access structure member through pointer, we make use of arrow operator. So STU is a pointer to structure, so which is assigned to the address of S1. Now STU and S1 are referencing the same structure values, but to access the member of the structure, we make use of arrow operator. Like STU, we found access name, we make use of this arrow operator. STU, we take minus sign, then greater than, it is called as arrow operator. STU arrow, then name. But in the previous program, we used a dot operator because STU was not a pointer, it was just an ordinary variable. But this time it is a pointer. To access a pointer from to access a member from pointer, we make use of arrow operator. So that is why we are calling STU arrow dot arrow name. So similarly, to display the roll number, we use STU arrow roll number. The output we got here is name is bond, so that is the value of STU arrow name is bond here, and roll number is 007. That is the value of STU arrow roll number will be displayed. So that is the, we can pass address of entire structure parameter to function. Okay, but to access the structure member through pointer, we make use of arrow operator. So that is important here. Now let us take one more program. Write a program to find the net salary of an employee if the gross salary and the directions are known. So basically, you are writing a program to calculate net salary of an employee, but the input must be given as gross salary and deduction, the deductions that you want to make in the salary, and after that we have to calculate the net salary. So this program is very, very simple. So we'll begin with hash include std io dot h, then void main. The main function is beginning here and it is ending here, and inside the main function itself you are taking the structure definition. So one thing I have to observe here, in the earlier programs what we did is we declared a defined structure outside the main function, but it is also possible to define it inside the main function. In this particular program, we are defining the structure inside the main function, that is also correct. So we know that the syntax of structure definition, it will begin with the struct keyword followed by name of the structure. The name is taken as emp, and the structure definition begins here, it ends here, and it is having three members. To store the employee details, we are using this particular structure. You know that employee in the company will be having a employee ID. So it's int emp ID. The second member is basically employee name, which is a character array with the size 10. And there are few more members which are representing employee salary, float, it's a gross salary, comma net salary, comma deduction. So these are the floating point members we are having in the structure. Next, we shall create or declare a structure variable. The syntax is known to us. The syntax is very simple. Struct emp. So that is the name of the structure. That is emp here. And the structure variable name, that is emp1. Now let us read values for the members of the structure. First one is employee ID. Let us read value for employee ID. Assign value to the employee ID. Printf. Enter the employee ID, and we are reading it using scanf here. Employee ID is of type integer. We take percentage p here, comma ampersand. How do you access the structure member using a structure variable? Here we make use of dot operator. It's emp1 dot emp ID. So we are reading value for employee ID of the structure variable emp1. Next one. So similarly, read employee name. Enter employee name. And use scanf to read employee name, percentages, comma emp1 dot name. You are reading value for the second member, that is name. Next one, we supposed to read gross salary of the employee. So again, we take a printf, display a message for the user, that is enter gross salary, and we read the gross salary using the scanf here. Here gross salary is of the type float here, so the type specifier must be taken as float, sorry, percentages, comma ampersand emp1. So that is the structure variable name dot the member name is gross underscore sal. So you are reading value for this particular variable. We enter the gross salary of the employee. Next, we'll have to enter the details of the deductions. how much deductions we'll have to make for that particular employee. We need to enter here. We enter the deductions. We take the scanf here. Here you are reading value for the deduction variable. So percentage F comma ampersand EMP1 dot deduction. The deduction is accessed through dot operator using EMP1. EMP1 dot deduction. Next we'll have to calculate the employee net salary. So that is net salary is equal to it is accessed like this. EMP1 dot net salary is equal to it's a gross salary minus deduction. EMP1 dot gross salary minus EMP1 dot deduction. So gross salary minus deduction will be the employees net salary or take home salary. And after calculating net salary, we'll have to display the details. Printf employee details. First we shall display the employee ID. So that is the value of EMP ID. It can be accessed through EMP1 dot EMP ID. Next one, display the employee name. Okay, employee name is equal to you are displaying the value of EMP1 dot name. So it will be substituted here. So that is a placeholder. So similarly display the gross salary. So that is EMP1 dot gross underscore sal. That is the member we are accessing to display its value. So similarly display the deduction is equal to you display the value of EMP1 dot deduction. Finally we will display the net salary. So that is EMP1 dot net salary. So that is how we can display the employee details with the net salary. Now let us run this program and check the output here. So the program is already written. So let me run this program to check the output. So this program is being compiled. It is asking us to enter the employee ID. First of all, you are reading the employee ID here. So we are supposed to enter the employee ID. I'll take it as 1. So 1 is the employee number. Then it is asking us to enter employee name. So this statement is asking us to enter employee name. So employee ID is set to, that is EMP1 dot EMP ID is set to 1 here. Now it is asking for EMP1 dot name. So I'll enter employee name as Ravi. So that is name of the employee. Next it is asking us to enter the gross salary. You are reading value for the structure member gross underscore sal. EMP1 dot gross underscore sal. So I'll enter gross salary as 40,000. So let me enter gross salary as 40,000. Next it is asking us to enter deductions. Okay, so employee has got a deduction of 5,000. Okay, after deduction we have to calculate net salary as gross salary minus deduction. It will be 40,000 minus 5,000. The net salary will be, our take home salary will be 35,000. Now it is displaying the employee details here. Okay, the employee details are employee ID is 1, employee name it's Ravi, gross salary it is 40,000.000 because I have taken it as a float, so it is printing fractional part as 000, and deduction we entered as 5,000, net salary we got it as 35,000. Now let us move on to the next program. Next program is write a program that takes book ID, author name, publisher name and price for a book as input and print the same information as the output. So you'll be writing a program that takes a book ID, author name, publisher name and price of the book as input and display the same information on the screen as the output. So this program is very simple. We'll have to define a structure and we'll have to read the value for structure members and display the values. So we'll have to begin with hash include std aval.h, then we have got void main, and inside the main you are defining a structure. We know the syntax of structure declaration. It will begin with the keyword struct followed by name of the structure. Let us take it as book because you want to maintain the information related to book in this particular structure. The suitable name for the structure is book here, and it is going to begin here, it is going to end here, and it is having 4 members. The first one is book ID, so let us take it as an integer. Second one is author name, it is basically a string, you take it as a character array with the size of 20. The third field is the publisher. The third member of the structure is publisher name. It is also a string. It must be taken as character array with size 20. And last one is the price of the book. It is taken as a float. And the structure definition is closing here. And book one is basically structure variable. It can be created in this way that we already learned. And it should end with the semicolon. So book one is a variable of the structure book. Now we'll have to enter the details of book. Printf, enter book ID, read it using scanf here. Book ID is integer, you take %d, %. So we access the structure name here using dot operator. The syntax is structure variable, that is book one dot the first member, that is book underscore id. Similarly, printf, enter author name, read the author name. The second member is a string here, so you take %s, book one, so that is structure variable dot member name is author underscore name. Next, similarly read publisher name, that is book one dot publisher name. So finally we have to read price of the book. So you should take %f here because the price member is float typed. The type specifier here is %f, %. The structure variable is book one dot the member name is price. So similarly you have to display the details here using printf. Book details are, first of all let us print the book ID. So there is a placeholder %d where actually you have to display book one dot book ID. Then display the author name, that is book one dot author underscore name. Display the publisher details here, book one dot publisher underscore name. Final display book price. Here actually we substitute the value of book one dot price. So let me run this program again. Let us run the program again. So let us give input here, asking us to enter book ID 123, author name Dennis Richer. Okay, I'll take it as Dennis. Publisher name, let us take it as Pearson. And price of the book, let us take it as 400 rupees. Displaying output like this. Book ID is 123, author name is Dennis, publisher is Pearson, book price, it is displaying it as 400. So I'm going to run one more program, that is passing structure as a parameter. Let us see how that program is going to be executed. So I'll uncomment this particular program which is already written. Now I'll see how the changes. I want to go with the step-by-step execution to understand the flow of the program. So I'll go to debug option, we know already. So let us start the execution by clicking start option. Now it has come here. Okay, we'll go with the step-by-step execution. Okay. So printf has executed. Now scanner is asking us to enter student name. So I'll take it as Ravi as a student name. Okay. So you can see, okay, this is a structure variable S1 and the name is set to Ravi name. So this is the value stored here. Okay, the size of the name is 50 here, and the remaining values are garbage values that we can see here. Next, go to the next statement. Next we need to enter roll number. Scanf is asking us to enter roll number. So this time I'll enter roll number as 23. Now let us see. Okay, just look at the roll number field of the structure variable S1. S1 dot roll number is set to 23. Okay, now display function will be called here with the parameter as the structure variable S1. Okay. Now it is assigned to STU. So S1 is assigned to STU. Okay. Now control came to the function definition. Okay, it will print the value of STU dot name. So that is Ravi. Okay, S1 dot name is assigned to STU dot name. It is basically passed by value. If you print its value, it is displaying it as Ravi. Next, I'll go to next one. Okay, the next statement we got the student roll number as 12. So that is it is 23. It has got displayed, and we return back to the caller and we terminate. So that is we can pass a structure variable as a parameter for the function. So this completes structure. Thank you.